everyone. It's Diana from the Understand Energy teaching team. And today I'm going to give you a little introduction to nuclear energy. What do we mean by that? So nuclear energy comes in two broad flavors, nuclear fission and nuclear fusion. In both of these categories, we are harnessing the power of the atom. And so we are getting energy out of the nuclear binding energy of these atoms. So with nuclear fission, what are we doing? So fission, we're breaking things apart. For nuclear fission, we are taking relatively large molecules, often uranium, hitting them with a neutron that makes them break apart. And when they're breaking apart to form smaller atoms, they're releasing neutrons and releasing a lot of energy. For nuclear fusion, we're doing the opposite. We're often taking small molecules, squishing them together to form a new molecule. And so here on Earth, we're often using isotopes of hydrogen, so deuterium and tritium, squeezing those together, forming helium. And when you squeeze that together, you get a lot of energy out of those atoms. We're talking about a lot of energy. What do we mean? So the power of the atom, this is Einstein's equation. Energy equals mass times the speed of light squared. It's a very big number. So there are small changes in mass when you're going to a more stable atom. So whether you're splitting apart those big unstable atoms in fission to make smaller atoms, or you're pushing two nuclei together to form a new nucleus from hydrogen to helium, you're releasing a lot of energy. So in that sense, the reason people get really excited about both types of nuclear energy, both fission and fusion, is because the nuclear fuels are astoundingly energy dense. So this chart is just giving you a sense of that. If you had a 1 gigawatt power plant, so that's a pretty significantly sized power plant, how much fuel would it require? If it was a coal-fired power plant, you're looking at 191 trains of 110 cars of coal to power that power plant for a year. For nuclear fission, you're only looking at 1 railcar load. And for nuclear fusion, you're only looking at filling up a pickup truck with its fuel. So nuclear fuels are very energy dense. And that's one of the reasons proponents really like nuclear energy. Another reason proponents like nuclear energy, both the flavor that's fission and the flavor that's fusion, is that there's no greenhouse gas emissions and there's no air pollution. Now, these two flavors are at very different stages of development. Nuclear fission is something we've been using commercially to create electricity through a steam cycle power plant since the 1960s. Today, it provides about 10% of the world's electricity production, and there's over 11 countries in the world that rely on nuclear fission for 30% or more of their electricity production. So it is a very big part, it's a very big contributor to world electricity production. Nuclear fusion is still in the research phase and has been in the research phase for a long time. We are starting to see milestones in nuclear fusion happen on the physics side and the technology side. We've only recently seen where we've actually been able to get more energy out of a nuclear fusion reaction than we had to put in to make the fusion reaction happen. But it is still a ways away from contributing to electricity production at a commercial scale. One of the big differences between fission and fusion is the waste. So nuclear fission creates long-lived radioactive waste that lasts for 200,000 plus years, radioactive waste that we haven't figured out how to deal with. We don't know how to keep it safe for that time frame. Nuclear fusion does not create radioactive waste. We are often combining, like I said, hydrogen isotopes to create helium. So there's no radioactive waste with that. So what's happening in these two phases? Nuclear fission, we're starting to see some plants shut down. There's safety concerns, especially after things like the tsunami in Fukushima and the impact on the nuclear power plant there. It is still growing in parts of the world, though, in much of China, some in the Middle East. And there's excitement about having smaller, more modular reactors that would still be powered by fission, but may have some more inherent safety built into those systems. So that's kind of what's going on in nuclear fission. Nuclear fusion, like I said, very much research phase, and that research is funded by governments, by universities, and more recently has really come on stage in climate tech in startups and venture capital. So milestones are being met, breakthrough is happening, but much still needs to occur on the technological side before it can contribute in a commercial manner. That's just a brief introduction to these two flavors of nuclear energy. If you want to find out more about either of them, check out our nuclear fission page and our nuclear fusion page to find out more.